In the land of Midian, the shepherd Moshe tended his flock. A single lamb strayed from the herd. Moshe followed it and found it drinking from a pool of water. I hadn't known you were thirsty. Your young legs must be tired.
Und hat sich dann noch gebracht zurück in den Eder, ein Stadlus Miyuchodo, was sie gewähnt, Davke der Fall, was sie gewähnt, Asep Zuro. Wer sagt im Medisch, hat der Pfarrer der Ebischter gesagt, wenn er gehe zu Mischen, als er Reu zu seiner Reis Reu.
Moshe led the people from Egypt and brought them the Torah. Each day, for 40 years, he tended to their every need. They stood in line to speak with him, and he counseled each one. When he finally brought them to the edge of the promised land, he was told that he would not be allowed to enter. Before he passed on, he asked God to choose the next leader. Appoint someone, he asked, who can relate to the unique needs of each of them. Through the ages and across the many exiles, God appointed leaders who were sensitive and compassionate. They would concern themselves with people's diverse needs, spiritual and material, profound and petty. By the 1600s, centuries of bitter exile had taken their toll on the Jewish diaspora. Their families murdered, and their villages destroyed by pogroms. Thousands congregated in cities where there simply was not enough to go around. Impoverished and demoralized, they lacked even the most basic necessities. With their families and institutions destroyed, education became an unaffordable luxury. The scholars looked down on the uneducated masses who became estranged from the Torah. A Torah scholar, Rabbi Yisroel Baal Shem Tov, began to mingle incognito among the common folk. He rallied a group of disciples to pay heed to their brethren in distress. Helping people find new ways to earn a livelihood, he restored their confidence and helped them put bread on their table. With stories and parables, he inspired them, explaining lofty Torah concepts in plain language. His caring revived a hidden spark within them. Empowered, the people awakened their connection to Torah and their Father in Heaven. Hasidic Rebbes that would follow him would become known for their kindness and empathy.
Und der Field, als sie damit dafür alles helfen. Ist allein gegangen, ist getan, dem Tal ist allein gegangen, und getan, kohle in Jonne, was mehr nicht, wie Kuch Neppisch, ist das Martin, die das alles helfen, der Jeld ist. Ist sein Dich in seiner Wede vertrieben, bei ihm auch in Puri, in Amok im Kodisch, hat der Field, als sie da, bis sie, ha, Joro,
In the 20th century, the Jewish people were once again vulnerable and defenseless. After suffering unspeakable horrors, people were turned into numbers. A generation was left orphaned, yearning for warmth and affection. As their shattered remnants took refuge in America, a sensitive and reserved rabbi arrived who took the time to worry for their simplest problems.
You know, the Rebbe didn't know me, didn't know my mother, didn't know anyone from the mishpacha. And when I looked at him, I saw tears. You know, it like as if he was my brother.
He said, well, you know how I feel. I believe that is your place and you should stay there. But I am looking at your wife's eyes and I see in them that she's rather unhappy where she is. And therefore, I will say, yes, go.
You know, the Rebbe asked for my husband. I explained that he wasn't at home then. And then the Rebbe said to me, nu, was macht das Kind? How is the baby? Is he eating now? Is it better? And I said, yes.
And the last few words of the Rebbe were, kach ani margish tsa'ara. This is how I feel her pain.
A Jewish nation, more disparate than ever, flocked to his door. But he exhibited total devotion to each and every one of them. Where they had previously been hounded and banished, in his warmth, they now felt loved and cared for. To each, he gave his full attention, making it clear that no matter how simple and trivial, if it was important to them, it was, in fact, of great consequence.